Hey there, I think you know by now that I'm not much of a gamer, since I said so in my first video. But YouTube is weird. You tend to get pulled into a click, and gaming is the one I'm in. I blame Alorian for that, for being so flipping good at carrying on the Aussie tradition, while not being paid for it. Anyway, as you may have noticed by now, I've branched out a bit in my topics. This is yet another new series called Philosophy and Religion. I've been working on an evolution debate video for some time, but I just can't get it right, so I've decided to do this one first. Now, since this is such a complex topic, I've asked my beagle, Dum Dum, to assist with the AVA cue cards. Okay, that's not his real name, but he seems to respond to it better. And I can't call him Stupid Beagle. We already call the dachshund stupid. Bursel, Kitson, Fraggle, Dum Dum! The cue card is upside down. Yeah, that's better. Anyway, today we're going to talk about the problem of desire. The opening rant you heard from Matt Johnson, better known as the, sort of poses the question nicely. What do we do with our desires? Most people believe that if we give in to our desires all the time, it will destroy our lives. Consider alcoholism or other addictions. What's his answer? Dum Dum, play the end of the track.
The only true freedom is freedom from the heart's desires. And the only true happiness this way lies.
His answer sounds like nihilism at first, but I really think it's more like Buddhist dualism. If we just pretend desires aren't there, then we'll be happy. We just need to find nirvana.
In my head, I'm so ugly. That's okay, 'cause so are you.
Not that nirvana, you crazy beagle. Ugh. Anyway, if this answer doesn't satisfy you, and it certainly doesn't satisfy me, then you have to figure out what to do about your desires. There's always hedonism, of course. Tempting, but I doubt very much that happiness lies in that direction. So I've tried it without much success. So then, do we live like Puritans, denying anything that might actually feel good? Sorry, but that doesn't make any sense to me either. I can't see being happy in a life of denying yourself. Or a life of denial either. Do you really think Tom Cruise is happy? No, in my opinion, desires are real and need to be dealt with sensibly.
Dude, can't we just decide for ourselves what our code of ethics should be and follow that?
Nice idea, but if the Apostle Paul couldn't do it, then how can I expect to? I was addicted to Joust for a while. Well, here's where I draw on what I know, which isn't all that much. I know that the original Dave, King David himself, said this about desires. Okay, so if he was right, what does that mean? Well, the Jews of Roman times thought it meant that if you just do what the law says, you'll get everything you want. Slip up and you're done. It's sort of confusionist, really. But I don't think that's what it means at all. Seriously, this is about as reasonable as suggesting that all the pantheons in the world have the same source. I mean, sure, Mars and Aries are the same, but where do gods like Asherah, Tyr, and Quetzalcoatl come from?
Dude. Tangent alert.
Sorry. So if you can't get everything you want by just being good, what do you do? Sorry, Mick Jagger, but just telling me I can't get it isn't good enough. Well, unfortunately, I don't actually have an answer for this question. I can, however, tell you what someone once told me. That if you follow this verse correctly, or maybe this one, that your desires will begin to coincide with your beliefs. So stop wanting the things that are bad for you and start wanting the good stuff.
Good stuff, Maynard.
So there's your options. One, deny they exist. Two, give in to them. Three, be a legalist. Or four, focus on a higher purpose. Try them all if that's what it takes. Me, I'm just sitting on the fence watching.
Rosary!
About love and all the crazy things that it'll make a person do.
side, don't you sleep till you feel okay. Now I'm gonna go my way, but my hands are clean today.